Hello guys, today we will study the ocular artifact removal from the EEG signal using S-transform. S-transform stands for Stockwell transform here, and please visit my webpage for more information, and you can reach me from here on these two mail IDs. This is the IEEE paper link, the link from where you can download the paper, IEEE paper, which we will implement today. I will explain you instruction by instruction so that you won't have any problem in understanding the instruction. First, what I did, I used the plot ATM function to incorporate the EEG signal which was affected by the ocular artifact. This is my EEG signal which I have downloaded from the PhysioNet. You can download it from the PhysioNet as well. Okay. Next, what I did, this is my signal X. This is my EEG signal X. Then what I did, I took the S transform, the Stockwell transform. The Stockwell transform. On the ocular artifact incorporated EEG signal. Then what I did, as per in the paper, we have to pass the signal which was affected. We have to pass the transform signal of EEG through the low pass filter with the cutoff frequency 16 Hz, and the sampling frequency which I took is 200. And from here, this is my low pass filter P. So I will pass my signal ST, as you can see here, ST here, ST here. I'm gonna pass my signal ST, the transform signal, through this filter, and the output is P. Now I have to filter this signal. Basically, I want to denoise this signal by using this transform. So what I'm gonna do, I will write a function for the threshold. This is the formula which is given in the paper for the threshold. From this you can find the threshold, and what are we doing? We are using the filtered signal, as you can see for yourself, the P. So what do we do? We will find the threshold for every column vector in the signal. This is just the multiplication factor, multiplying factor, and its value is 0 to 1, between 0 to 1. And I store the size of P in M and N. M represents the number of column, and M represents the number of rows, and N represents the number of columns. And I apply the loop finally for each element in the signal P, for I equals to 1 is to M, and for J equals to 1 is to N. If the absolute value of F, basically I in this loop I am checking every value in the vector P. If this value is greater than threshold, then I'm gonna multiply this value with MF. Otherwise, I will leave this value as it is. So after this, my transform signal got filtered, and then I'm gonna find the inverse S transform, inverse Stockwell transform, and store it in the variable IST. And now I'm gonna plot it. As you can see for yourself, I'm running this program. This is my denoised signal, and this is my signal. This is the signal of the EEG signal with ocular artifacts, and as you can see here, this is my denoised signal. The signal got denoised from this algorithm. So that's it for today guys. Thanks for watching.